खराब हो गए थे
आसाम में कितना दिन रखा है भाई? अभी तबियत पानी अच्छा है ना? तबियत पानी अच्छा है? नीचे कर
तो
Selamat datang, Bay.
Abah,
Abah, Alhamdulillah.
Naik mila lagi
ke? Hah? Nih, gadi aini nabi. Yang pergi sahaja jatuh.
You speak English? Oh, you speak English? How are you feeling? कैसा लग रहा है? तकलीफ नहीं हो रही? चांद को भगा दिया क्या?
नहीं उधर मायने में
हमारा चांद किसके ऊपर चांद?
नहीं बाहर वाले का चांद तुम्हारा देखो क्या बाहर वाले
Thank you. आज राजू गुस्से में है तू यार, आज तो गुस्से में है।
गुस्से में नहीं, गिराक नहीं लग रहा है, लगता है ऐसा थोड़ी। कभी जाना मिलता जाता से घंटे में 200 रुपये बन जाते, कभी नहीं तो एक घंटा एक मौत का, एक धंधे का कोई भरोसा है?
बेटा ले लो, आप सब ले लो साथ बेटा। इधर रहते तो इधर रहते क्या?
बांद्रा किस नगर?
अच्छा अच्छा, क्या करता है? क्या
काम करता है?
इधर
बांद्रा में तरीके से।
बहुत कचरा भरे ले तो बोलता अभी साफ किया मैंने।
उनके पास ही गया था बीच में
कभी,
बीच में साफ किया था
फिर भर गया। हेलो
चलाओगा बच्ची
And this is Sheikh Mehboob.
Yes.
Sheikh Mehboob.
Sheikh Mehboob.
From Gulbarga, Karnataka. And this young boy, I paid for his ear cleaning because I needed someone to sit with Sheikh Mehboob Saab, and I wanted to document the ear cleaning process. And this is an amazing, intricate process as such.
Yes, yes.
I'm very grateful to you, young man. Thank you very much. God bless you. So after almost 2 months, or maybe more, I come to the Talao and having my ears cleaned by Nabi. I just took a chance. I wasn't sure he'll be here. It's about 6:30 now. Good evening. अभी किधर गए?
गांव गए ना।
और वो महबूब?
वो भी गांव में।
अच्छा,
हम लोग भी जा
रहे हैं। ये सब तुम्हारा पीछे अड्डा बना दिया क्या? सब औरत लोग सोड़े ला है।
हाँ, रात भर इधर ही सोते थे।
हाँ,
सब टप्पर को
गलत है। वीडियो चल रहा है, बोल ना, आगे बढ़िए। वीडियो चल रहा है मेरा, आगे बढ़िए ना। माहिती मला माहिती आहे तुम्ही कसं आहे, बरं आहे ना? जय महाराष्ट्र। धंधा नहीं हुआ क्या? क्या बात कर रहे
हैं? जो 4 घंटा ऐसे बैठा था,
फिर
200-250 रुपये धंधा हो
गया। कितना?
200-250।
बस तेरा होना कितना चाहिए?
300-400 होते हैं।
अच्छा,
पूरा दिन में 400
हो गया तुम्हारा?
क्यों
कौन है
वो मालिश करने?
कभी आगे बैठता, कभी पीछे बैठता, एक या तो बदली करो, उधर लगाएगा उधर बैठेगा।
जगह है ना, लगा ना इधर
इधर इधर ही ऐसे गंदगी पे लगाएंगे तुम्हारा चलेगा धंधा? पहले झाड़ू लगाएंगे ऊपर नीचे।
रुको, फिर आते घोड़े पे पहले?
नहीं, घोड़े पे नहीं, निकाल लो ना तुम, पहले निकाल लो ना।
कौन है फिर? क्या को मत,
घोड़े पे नहीं, तू घोड़े पे आ जा।
हम लोग रहते नहीं अंदर,
इधर बैठेगा दो दिन, उधर बैठेगा।
पटका देना और राजू पटका देने का आसाम से है लगता morning from Bandra, Talao. I've come normally dressed. The reason is I had to go to the passport office. And with my turban and with my earrings and with my things on my neck, people would think I'm some terrorist or jihadi. So I decided to tone down my dressing. And now I'm at Bandra Talao with Kasim Bhai.
the year three. I feel almost semi naked, yeah, without my turban, without my paraphernalia that I wear. I don't have trousers, I don't have shirts, I don't have jeans. But I have this one shirt, a waistcoat and breeches that I bought in the passport office to get my passport renewed. 10 years I had my passport, but I've never been abroad. I have no love for going abroad. I prefer India. I want to live in India, I want to die in India. I had money, then I would go to China and become a Shaolin monk at the age of 68. Not to learn Kung Fu or martial arts, just to get peace of mind. And discipline my volatile nature, my anger. I might go and stay for a few days in a Buddhist monastery . This is pretty low because of the rains. I did a film, the costumes, when the film got shelved. I'm going through really bad times. I've just come back from Assam. I got to shoot the Kamakya Mela, Kamakya Ambubachi Mela. And here I must tell you, I know I shouldn't be talking much, but I must tell you, it was a Hindu gentleman who I met last year in Kamakya, who paid for my ticket, flight ticket, who paid for my hotel stay, simply because of one reason. He said, you promote Hinduism as a message of peace. You are the only Muslim I've seen that wants Hindu-Muslim amity. I told him, beneath our skin, deep down, we are all human. I mean, being Hindu, Muslim, Christian, Jew, does not really matter. If you're not a good human being, then it is unnecessary being whatever religion you represent. So this is Kasim Bhai. Let's get back to him. And this is, I'm in the rains, mind you. There's no business at all. A few days back, I met him at Jamaat-e-Jamhooriya and he was in a very bad shape. This Kasim Bhai, I gave him some money. So he told me that day he had no money to eat food. And he said that you gave me money, I ate food. So this is it. Somehow we help each other. And having so much of money and not being able to help others, I think that is crazy. The most beautiful thing in this world is compassion. If you don't have compassion, your humanity, your religiosity, your spirituality is meaningless. Should feel. I know people who feed cats, who feed dogs, who feed crows, who feed birds, who feed ants. But do they really feed human beings? No, they don't care a shit for human beings. And this is what hurts me deep down. I do whatever I am not showing off, I'm not boasting. I do help people. I help poor, I help beggars. But I don't want to blow my trumpet. I do it because God has given me one life. And if I can save other people's lives, why not? I don't want any award or reward. I don't even want to go to heaven. And I'm 72, nubile virgin. That is not my kind of religiosity. I'm not interested at all. I mean, this jihadi, killing people in the churches and destroying Sufi dargahs, Imam bargahs. This is not Islam. This is not the Islam that I believe in at all. My Islam is an Islam of peace and brotherhood, an Islam that respects every religion possible. I mean, I distance myself from any God that tells you to kill people. I mean, that cannot be a God. Because God created people and He kills them through disasters or whatever natural causes. We have no right to kill people. This is what I believe. And this is why the Muslims on YouTube you know, the trolls, the YouTube trolls on my discussion table, they abuse my mother, my sister, my dead mother, mind you. And this is their Islam. I have nothing against this, against them, but I, whatever I am, they want to know whether Sufis pray namaz. Who the hell are you to ask them? That's their problem. They say namaz, don't say namaz. Who are you? Are you God's representative on earth? I am not a mullah. I am not a preacher. I am not a holistic healer. I don't believe in dua tabiz. I believe in God and He helps. When I'm falling down, sometimes I get up. And when I get up, I say, Ya Ali, mother. So I am what I am. I was born in a Shia mother's womb. I'm not going to forget that. That was my first step into spirituality. And because of her, and whatever you are, whether you're a Muslim or a Hindu or whether you're any community, if you don't have a good parentage and good upbringing and good education, I think your views, your ideology is all balls. This I will reiterate. I know this is not the platform to talk about my religiosity, but I'm sitting in the rains and these are the thoughts that are hitting me like raindrops. Ah. And this is Kasim Bhai. And I'm not... He has an umbrella, but if I hold the umbrella, I can't shoot this video. Karo, jaldi karo. And these are the people that have made me famous. The ear cleaners of Bandra Talao. Both Kasim Bhai, Nabi, Raju, Mehboob, and the guy who passed away, Chand Hussain. These are the people. And I told their story not because of the ear cleaning. I have no fetish for it. I only told their story because there was a fear of their being evicted from here. This Bandra Talao is being refurbished and it's going to be renovated. I don't know whether they will be here. And this is the last of the Bandra Talao ear cleaners. Once they are gone, they are gone. These are old guys. These are actually farmers, you know. They have their farms, but they want to supplement their income. Their children will never be ear cleaners. We're getting the children educated. This is the beauty of the ear cleaners of Bandra Talao. And I don't know one thing, I sometimes surprised about the YouTube. I have discontinued, disabled my comment box because I don't want to be abused. For what? I shoot with my camera, I shoot my time. And there is no agenda of hate, there is no animosity. So why should I be abused? You don't like what I shoot, too bad. You don't see my videos, just move on. But I'm not going to shoot what you shoot. You shoot nothing. You don't even have fucking original content. I shoot original content. I don't go to your channel. I don't shit on your channel's comment box. So why should you shit on my comment box? So the only place where they shit, and which is on my comments on review, is the discussion tab of YouTube. I could disable that, but I just kept it because I've got some good friends among these YouTubes. The subscribers. So that is why I don't subscribe to those who subscribe to my channel, and I leave it to God. So I think I will. And the rain has not stopped. I'm coming here after almost 2 months. So thanks a lot to all of you. Take care. All the best.